For about 1,000 years between the 6th and the 16th century, Java was ruled by a succession of Hindu-Buddhist empires, of which three were extremely powerful. There were the Sailendras in East Java, which were Buddhist and who left us the monumental UNESCO World Heritage Site of Borobudur, the Temple Mountain. Beside them were the Sanjayas, who ruled between the 8th and the 10th century, and they left us the other UNESCO World Heritage Site monument, the Hindu temple of Prambanan. And then there was the great Majapahit Empire, which ruled from between the 13th century to the 16th century out of their eastern Javanese base of Trowulan. We are very, very lucky to have with us in this exhibition a masterpiece of art from the Majapahit Empire that we have managed to loan from the National Museum of Indonesia in Jakarta. This is the statue of Queen Tribhuwana, depicted as the mother goddess in Hindu mythology, the goddess Parvati. Who was Queen Tribhuwana? Now, Queen Tribhuwana was the third reigning monarch of the Majapahit Empire. She ruled between 1328 and 1350, and this period was also known to be when the Majapahit Empire was at its greatest extent and also its most illustrious culturally. Interestingly, this period also coincided with the existence of one of its most fascinating tributaries or vassal states. By this, I refer to the Kingdom of Singapura, which was located here on the banks of the Singapore River and what is today's Fort Canning Hill. The Kingdom of Singapore was a vassal to Majapahit. In the late 1300s, it is told in the Sejarah Melayu that the Majapahit empires attacked the Kingdom of Singapore, and the last king of Singapore went on to found the Malacca Sultanate. Growing up in Singapore, you learn about this existence of a mythical Majapahit empire, and you never know or have a sense of what exactly this particular empire looked like. So this statue shows you, provides a sort of tangible relic of what the Majapahit empire would have been. This is my favorite piece of art in this exhibition because of just how magnificent and how beautiful it is. I'd like to point out two very interesting details. The first is the fact that the statue is bedecked in glorious jewelry. And examples of this jewelry, which would have been made in gold at the time, we have actually displayed in this exhibition. And the jewelry comes from ACN's own collection. The second interesting detail I'd like to point out are the two vases that sit at the feet of the queen. These vases are Yuan Dynasty style vases, the Yuan Dynasty having ruled China during the period of the Majapahit Empire. If you've been paying attention to news about recent archaeological digs in Empress Place, you would know that the digs threw up thousands and thousands of porcelain shards that date to the Yuan Dynasty. So the significance of this statue here in the exhibition is firstly to provide a window onto the glory and the splendor of the Majapahit Empire, and secondly, to draw a link between Majapahit and Singapore through the Yuan Dynasty vases sitting at the goddess's feet and the thousands upon thousands of porcelain shards that were found just at ACM's doorstep.